Hi, greetings to everyone and welcome to our video lecture. And in today's lecture, we're going to discuss the introduction to agritourism and diversification. So a path to sustainable agricultural entrepreneurship in the Philippines. Okay, so before we start, we'd like to invite each and every one of you to please like, follow, and subscribe in our channel so that you will be updated for our recent videos related to agriculture and agribusiness. So your support is very appreciated, and this helps us to grow and continuously provide you with this quality content. Okay, so let's proceed to our lecture proper. So in the agritourism and diversification is today, context in the principles of agricultural entrepreneurship and marketing. So in this video, we're going to explore the concept of agritourism, its significance in the agricultural sector, and how it intertwines with diversification strategies. We also delve into a practical examples relevant to the Philippine setting. So, understanding agritourism. So the word agriculture and also tourism. Okay, so agritourism involves any agriculturally based operation or activity that brings visitors to a farm or a ranch. It merges the elements of agriculture and tourism that offers a visitors an opportunity to experience agricultural life firsthand. So the agritourism involves the what we call integration of the tourism activities into agricultural operation. So in the word tourism activities, so you came or you visit a place for relaxation, for at the same time bringing your family and your loved ones to that place to have a quality time. And having integrate with the agricultural operation, speaking of production, like for example, you have this agricultural operation that also gave your visitors a tourism experience, for example, at the same time, where your visitors will have the opportunity to observe or to have a first-hand experience on the operation of your farm. That will add also at the same time, it's also an educational contribution to them. It offers a unique experience for visitors while providing a additional revenue streams for farmers. It will well at the same time, the additional revenue streams, well, it starts from the entrance gate of your farm, and also the product of your farm will be displayed in your place, where your visitors will be able to have to purchase your products when they visit your farm. Okay, so let's explore some examples of agritourism initiatives in the Philippines. Okay, so example number one is the strawberry farm tours in Benguet. So one prominent example is the strawberry farm tour in Benguet, where the visitors have the opportunity to pick fresh strawberries and learn about the cultivation techniques. And while at the same time, they will be enjoying the scenic view of the countryside. So this initiative not only generates income for farmers, but also it promotes the local tourism and boosts the economy. Okay, another example is the Eco Farm Stays in Batangas. So this example is Eco Farm Stay in Batangas, where tourists can immerse themselves in rural life and participate in farm activities and enjoy organic meals sourced directly from the farm. These experiences provide a glimpse into sustainable agriculture practices while supporting local communities. Next is the JK Enchanted Farm, situated in Bulacan. So the social enterprise combines agriculture with tourism by offering farm tours, workshops, and organic produce sales, providing livelihood opportunities to our local communities. Next is the Dahilayan Adventure Park. So this one is located in Quibdon. And this park, it offers a range of activities, including zip lining, horseback riding, and pineapple plantation tour. And with this, it showcasing the region's agricultural bounty. So those are some of the examples. And there are a lot more. So what is the importance of agritourism? So it plays a crucial role in what we call a diversification of our agricultural activities. And it offers farmers an additional source of income beyond just having a traditional farming practices. Moreover, it promotes a what we call rural development by creating jobs and also stimulating economic growth in agricultural areas. So I still have more example, like for example here in the fruit farms. Many fruit farms across the country offer agritourism experience. So fruit farm, you will be visiting a orchard where visitors can pick fresh fruits and learn about cultivation techniques and even participate in cooking classes using farm fresh produce. How exciting that was. You will be part of those mentioned activities. And then rice terraces tourism. The iconic Banawi rice terraces in the Fugao province attracts tourists interested in learning about traditional rice farming practices, cultural heritage, and indigenous agriculture. And then organic farms. So with the growing demand for organic produce, organic farms in the Philippines have capitalized on agritourism by offering farm tours, organic farming workshops, and farm-to-table dining experiences. So the importance of diversification in agriculture refers to the strategy of expanding beyond your traditional farming activities. So you're not only limited of your production, but rather these activities will be included in your operation, in your overall farm operation. That could add additional income generating ventures. So this strategy is crucial for agricultural sustainability as well and the resilience to the face of various challenges such as market fluctuation, climate change, and evolving consumer preferences. So let's take a look at the diversification strategies in agritourism. Okay, so first is the value-added products. Farmers will have the opportunity to expand their range of products by creating a what we call value-added, like jams, jellies, sauces, using ingredients grown on their farms. So this will be very inviting products for your visitors. These goods can be marketed directly to your customers or to your visitors and sold at the market or offered through online platforms. Since nowadays, digital marketing is somehow very useful. Using social medias and other platforms can be very useful. So transforming the farm produce into value-added products such as your jams, sauces, or crafts will allow you to change premium prices and attract specific customer segments. And then the farm stay accommodation. So this one, when you are offering a farm stay accommodation, you will be providing for your visitors an additional revenue stream. And visitors get the experience of rural living while farming generates income through lodging and your hospitality services. Next is your educational workshop. So organizing a workshop on topics like sustainable farming practices, organic gardening, and rural crops not only generates income but also enhances the educational aspect of agro or agri-tourism. And then agri-tainment, offering a recreational activities like fishing, camping, or a petting zoos can attract families and outdoors enthusiasts to the farm. And then agroforestry, integrating tree crops with traditional agriculture can improve soil health, provide additional income from timbers or fruits, and enhance biodiversity. So here are some of the examples of our marketing strategies for agritourism. Effective marketing is essential for the success of agritourism venture. So you need to be seen. You need to attract tourists. You need to attract customers. So here are some of the marketing strategies to consider. First is your digital presence. Establishing a strong online presence. So when you check in your cell phone or you're in your desktop, when you type agritourism in Iloilo, for example, you can be seen through digital presence. So that's why, if possible, if you can have website and social media platform, this digital presence will help you reach a wider audience and attract a more potential visitors. Okay, next is collaboration. So collaborating with local tourist boards for our tourism department in every LGU, your travel agencies and hotels can help promote agritourism destination and attract more visitors. And then promotional events. Hosting a promotional event such as farm festivals, agritourism fairs, and culinary showcases can create buzz and attract tourists. So what are the benefits of agritourism? Okay, so let's discuss the benefits of agritourism for both our farmers and to our local economy. First benefit is additional income. Agritourism provides our farmers with an additional source of income, reducing their reliance on just a traditional farming alone. And then rural development, by attracting tourists in your area, agritourism will stimulate a what we call economic growth, because people will come there and then they will need to buy, and then people in your place will have a livelihood. And then that will start an economic growth, creates employment opportunities, and improve infrastructure, since people are used to go there. Then your local, then part of the government will be able to decide someday to improve the roads, if the road is not yet developed. So that's part of your farm infrastructure developments to our rural areas to help our farmers connect to the market. And then cultural exchange. Agritourism promotes cultural exchange and appreciation for local traditions, cuisine, and customs. And then environmental conservation. Sustainable agritourism practices can help preserve our natural resources and also promote biodiversity conservation. So let's take a look at some of the challenges consideration. So this area, the challenges are always part of any venture. There's no perfect business venture, but these challenges will help us to understand the complexity of this operation. Okay, so while agritourism offers number of benefits, it also presents some challenges and consideration that farmers need to address. First is the infrastructure. The limited infrastructure such as roads, the accommodation, and the amenities may hinder the development of agritourism destination. But at the same time, it's an opportunity. Okay, then marketing and promotion. Effective marketing strategies are essential to attract visitors and create awareness about agritourism offerings. And then the seasonality. Agritourism activities may be seasonal, requiring our farmers to diversify their offerings or implement off-season attraction. And then sustainability. It's crucial to balance tourism activities with environmental conservation efforts to ensure the long-term sustainability of agritourism venture. So in conclusion, in summary, the integration of agritourisms and diversification stands as the vital pillar of agricultural entrepreneurship and marketing in the Philippines. Through these approaches, farmers can unlock fresh revenue streams, advocate for sustainable method, and bolster a rural advancement. Through ingenuity, innovation, and a profound attachment to the land, the prospects for agricultural entrepreneurs are boundless. To conclude, agritourism emerges as an enticing avenue for agricultural entrepreneurs to broaden their income source, advocate for sustainability, and foster a rural progress. By capitalizing on the distinct strength of Philippine agriculture and embracing inventive approaches, our farmers can offer a memorable experiences to tourists while securing a promising future for themselves and their communities. So in essence, the agritourism will present a promising avenue for our farmers to expand their income streams and foster a rural development. By seamlessly integrating agritourism with diversification strategies, farmers can maximize potential of their agricultural assets while delving a unique experience to their visitors. So thank you for attending for today's lecture. And for further reading and references, please see the materials listed on the slide and feel free to reach out if you have any questions and need additional information. Thank you very much and have a good day to everyone. I'll see you again on our next video lecture.